Hi, my name is Pedro and this is All My Function. This is the video number 8 of a series I'm creating to teach you about data visualizations using technologies like React, VisX, D3, and some others. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to create, finally, a bar chart. Well, in the last video, I taught you how to create an axis, and then before that, I taught you how to create a scale, and on this video, I'm going to get a rect, that is a rectangle in SVG, and basically put an axis on the left and one on the bottom, and then I'm gonna put the rects, the rectangles, on the middle, everything grouped, and then, yeah, it's gonna be useful. Maybe I can add a little bit of glitter on the top, adding some effects on hover, so let's see how it goes. So this is something that you have to understand about the charts, is that usually you have a margin, because you need to add a margin so the content inside doesn't get cropped when you create the chart. So this is a view of how it kind of works. So you have your SVG, that is this blue square, and then rectangle, and then you have this yellow one that is your actual chart. And between these things, nothing goes inside. There are some cases where you want the chart to be actually full width or not, but in this case I wanted to have a margin on all the sides. So let's start from the beginning. We always create a sandbox from Code Sandbox with the vanilla JS template. I'm going to delete this one, and I'm going to delete this one too. I'm going to create a bar chart, and I don't want to add attributes to it directly on a D3. So I want all the rects to have the fill of orange. And that's it for the styles. Now let's go to the code. I need to add D3 from D3 here. Everything as D3 from D3. Then let's get this step by step. Get data. And then after that, I need to define margins, define width, define height, define x scale. Actually, let's start with y scale. Define x scale, define y axis, define x axis. Then define bar. Yeah, I think that before this one, define SVG here, and then put everything together. That's the plan. So let's get the data set. That's the same one that I always get. Cool, now the margins. Margin is top first is 30, then the right is 30, the bottom is 30, and then left is 30. The width is 300, the height is 250, then the y scale is linear, so y equals D3 dot scale linear, and the first parameter that I always define is the domain, and the domain is going to be from 0 until the maximum value of these properties that is going to be a helper that I'm going to create. So y max is going to be math dot max spread all the values from the data map that I'm going to map all the values here. That's going to give me the 500. So y max, and then the domain is going to be from the bottom to the top. So it's height minus margin bottom. So it's height minus margin bottom until margin top. That's going to be from the bottom onto the top. And then, oops, I have the domain. This is the range. Now for the axis scale, the 3-scale bend. Scale bend is nice for bar charts. The domain here is going to be, it should be actually one array with like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but I can just use these ones. So just data for this one. And then the range is going to follow the same steps as this one. So it's going to start from left. So it's margin dot left, and then go until width minus margin dot right. And this is an array. Then I'm going to define the SVG. What? That is complaining. Oh, it's margin. So const SVG, v3 dot select, and select the body, then append an SVG, add attribute of width as width, and then of height as height. Now I need to define the y-axis. If I just create it without any transformation here, it's gonna go to the extreme left, and I don't wanna do that because it's gonna cut the content. So I'm gonna add a to-do that I'm gonna do on the later on the video, how to add margin here, and I'm gonna do the same here. So let's create the axis first. So x-axis is literally the 3 dot axis left. Oops, this is the y, right? Y-axis, and then I pass the y, I pass the scale. X-axis is gonna do the same thing. So axis bottom, and I'm gonna pass x. So to find the bars, this is nicer. So I get it directly from the SVG. So let's, I'm gonna append a group, right? So on the, put everything together, what I'm gonna do is going to svg.append g, and then on this g, I'm gonna call the things like the y-axis, the x-axis, I have to define the ticks here. So it's more trickier than I thought, but that's okay. Then I'm going to append g and call bars. That is the function I'm gonna create for this one. So let's first start with this one. Let's make it right. So let's comment out this part here. And you see that it's ugly here. That's because I basically have the ticks as a format. So what I'm gonna do is get, actually it's on the bottom, right? Dot tick format, and I get the D, and then D dot name, I guess. Yeah, then this is A, B, C, D, E. And then on the axis left, I want to do the same thing. So tick format, but on this one is the, actually on this one I don't need to because it's a scale linear and it's gonna get the value that it gets. Cool, but it's on the wrong place. You can see the axis bottom's on the top and the axis left is on the extreme left. So what I need to do is transform this into a function. So it's a G that is going to actually call this one. But first it needs to append, not append, it needs to add an attribute. and then call this function. The attribute can't be null. What I'm gonna add is a transform, and then it's gonna be translate, and then margin left, and here zero. So it's on the right place. I'm going to do the same thing for this one, and then add another thing here, and then transform this into a function. But this one, the transformation is gonna be, yeah, very different from zero onto height minus margin bottom. Oh, I don't need this third attribute. So yeah, now it's everything on the right place. I just need to define the bars. So to define the bars, I need to, and I don't need to add the margin here anymore. So the bars is, I need to bars, and then it's a function that receives the g, and then g dot select all, and then on the select all, I'm gonna select all the rects. That's the three thing, remember, it gets it all and then updates it and whatnot. Then data is the data, and then I'm gonna use the join. A join has three parameters, the enter, the update, and the exit. And what I'm gonna do on each one of these is, on enter, I'm going to append a rectangle, update is just update, and then on the exit, I'm gonna remove whatever is inside. Cool. Now I just need to add an attribute for x that is gonna be, yeah, I don't care about the data that is inside, so I'm gonna put this and I, and then I'm gonna get the skill and pass this I. Then for the attribute y, I actually care about this. Let's make this one x and this one I. It doesn't transform all the parameters, so that's fine to leave this one like this. Doesn't have prettier installed on this project, so it keeps it this way. Here I'm gonna pass it to y d, and it's just d. No, I got d dot value. It is the value that is inside. But it just means that I know now where they are on the y, on the and on the y and x. But I need the attribute of height on them. So height to be, each one of these is d, and then y d dot value. I pass the parameter, and then I think that the width is gonna make it appear. And then on the width, it's the good part is that I can just use x.bend width, and it's gonna return with the padding that I've defined here on the scale bend. Yeah, I didn't. So padding 0, 1. And then let's uncomment this one, and I can't. Width is not a function, of course not, and it's ugly. Well, let's see what happened. Let's add here 20. So each one of these properties have 20, but I don't need it because I saw that it was working before. So it's this one, and I think that the problem is actually on the x. So y zero minus, yeah, that's better. And then I'm checking it out just to make sure that I got everything right. It's not appearing in the page anymore. So yeah, I think I know what I messed up here. What I needed to actually do was not get the I from the x, because it returns undefined here. What I needed to do is get the actual D, that the data, and pass it here. And then if I append it, then that's correct. The caller here was wrong. And if I reload this page, adding everything together, it works. So now I have a useful bar chart that can be used in any application. Usually what people do is they customize things like hover effects. So then you can do something like this and it gets a little bit more interactive, and you can even add transitions and whatnot, but I'm not gonna do it right now. With these tabs, you can create any chart that you want. And it's really cool how D3 makes it so easy to create new charts. Now you know how to create a bar chart using D3 and Vanilla.js. You can do it with almost every type of chart, like line charts, area charts. The logic is the same. If you want to know how to put a chart like this on your React application, I'm going to teach you on the next video, so stay tuned. If you like the video, please subscribe and add a comment if you have any questions. Thumbs up really helps, and that's it. See you soon. Bye-bye.